Number one, a 1600 kilogram car is traveling over a hill that has a radius of curvature of 25 meters. The car is slowing down as it goes over the hill. It slows down at a constant rate from a speed of 25 meters per second to a speed of 10 meters per second over a distance of 50 meters, ending at the top of the hill. The net acceleration of the car at the top of the hill is most nearly, well, we must consider that there are possibly two accelerations to be measured here. The car is traveling along a circular path or hill, and they want you to calculate the acceleration right at the top of its path. But during this time, the object has been decelerating with a tangential acceleration that they claim it is constant. Now, this tangential acceleration depends on a change for velocity from 25 meters per second to 10 meters per second over a distance of 50 meters. This tangential acceleration then is going to be equal, according to the fifth kinematic equation, to the square of the final velocity minus the square of the initial velocity over twice the distance traveled. That's equal to 100 minus 625 divided by 100 meters, which is equal to negative 5.25 meters per second squared. Now, on the other hand, the object is also traveling along a circular path, which causes a radial acceleration or centripetal acceleration, and instantaneously, that's equal to the speed squared divided by the radius. Now, the radius of this curvature is 25 meters, and at that instant, the speed is 10 meters per second. So this radial acceleration is 100 divided by 25, which is equal to 4 meters per second squared. Therefore, the actual or net acceleration for this car is going to be the vector sum of these two accelerations, and that's going to be the square root of 5.25 squared plus 4 squared, which is approximately equal to 6.6 meters per second squared. That is option C.